Welcome back to GenLogin Academy.
This lesson is about read file and write file buttons. These buttons are very helpful when it comes to data scraping, logging in multiple accounts, and many more situations. Let's start with read file. Open the text file you want to read. In most cases, we choose line by line with delimiter mode. In this first example, we're going to read a text file that each line has only one variable, so we don't need the delimiter. Output variable, we choose mail. The automation normally reads from the first line to the last line. If you click random checkbox, it will read a random line. Let's start automation. Next example. We want to delete the line we just read. How could we do that? Simply click delete line after read. And let's see. Now, to make it more complicated and realistic, I will add password at the end of each line. And your mission is to read mail and password at the same time. Well, here comes the delimiter. Type a vertical bar. Right after that, set up a variable map value. First variable is mail, the second is password. Let's start automation. The line was separated into mail and password with vertical bar delimiter. Next, write file button. You can continue to write on an existing file or create a new one. I will name it output. Select a variable to write. There are three file options: txt text file, csv spreadsheet, and finally json cookie. Next, two write modes: override start from beginning, and append continues an existing file. I set the value of mail variable is line 1, and let's start automation. Oh, perfect. Repeat the same technique to write line 2. The last example will show you an advanced way to use write file button. The case is, I want to write many variables in the same line with a specific format. In order to do that, write the format of text you want into the input data box just like this. I just put a vertical bar in between the two variables. Let's see how it works. That's the end of lesson 6. See you next time.